Dear friends, we have just completed our theory on vector mathematics. Let us do some problems. Let us take a simple problem. There is a parallelogram, or say this is a rectangle, and it is named as A, B, C, D. And take this AC. What is the length of this AB? The length of AB is 4 and the length of BC is 3. Now, there is one problem, that what is the component of AC along AB? What is the component of AC vector along AB? So, we all are knowing that when a particular vector is making angle alpha with another vector, then the component of the first vector along the second vector will be the magnitude of first vector multiplied by cos alpha. So, here the first vector is AC, and AC is making some angle with AB, let us this theta. So, the component of AC along AB will be magnitude of AC and cos of theta. So, what is the magnitude of AC? When this is 4, this is 3, and we have already said this is a rectangle. So, this will be 4 square 3 square is equal to 5. So, cos theta will be AB upon AC, that means 4 upon 5 . Now what is the AC? AC is 5 multiplied by cos theta, so 4 will be the component of AC vector along AB. And this is very pretty much simple also, that this is AC. When we are putting some perpendicular to this along the AB, then this length will give the component of this AC vector. So, at first sight it is also giving that 4 is the component of AC vector along AB vector. Now, what will be component of AB vector along AC vector? AB vector along AC. So, now our vector is AB. Our vector is AB. And we want to calculate the component of AB along AC, this AC. So, what angle AB is making with AC? Again, this is making angle theta. So, what will be the component of AB? That is AB magnitude and multiplied by cos theta. So, AB is 4, cos theta is 0.8, 3.2 will be the component of AB along AC. Now, another problem, what is the component of this BC vector along AC? This BC vector along AC. So, see here, this is B and this is C and this is A, and this is making angle theta. So, we have to take, then we have to, what is the target? Target, what is the angle BC is making AC? So, BC, you can extend this upside, you can extend this in along the AC side. Then you can see that this BC is making angle, some angle alpha with AC. So, its magnitude will be BC cos alpha. So, this will be the component of BC along AC. So what is the BC? BC is 3. What is cos alpha? See, let us take this. This is theta, so this is theta. So alpha will be 90 minus theta. Alpha will be 90 minus theta. So this will be BC cos 90 degree minus theta. Now what is cos 90 degree minus theta? That is sine theta. Now what is sine theta? Sine theta is BC upon AC, that is 3 upon 5.6. So what is this BC? BC is 3 multiplied by 0.6, 1.8. So the component of BC along AC is 1.8. Now the problem can be asked in another way also. What is the component of BC along CA? BC along CA. So now the direction of this CA is changing. Like this is BC and this is CA. Okay. So now what is the angle between BC and CA? You just extend a little BC. See, BC is in this direction, CA is in this direction. So angle will be something like this. And this is gamma. We have extended this and this was alpha. So this gamma barabar will be 180 degree minus alpha. Alpha was 90 degree minus theta. So this will be 180 degree minus 90 degree plus theta. That means 90 degree plus theta degree. ठीक है? So this gamma barabar 90 degree plus theta degree. Then what will be the component of BC along CA? So BC magnitude and the angle it is making with CA. The angle is making gamma. So this will be cos of gamma. And that means BC cos of 90 degree plus theta degree. Now 90 degree plus cos of 90 degree plus theta degree is equal to minus sine of 90 degree plus 90 minus sine theta. So this will be BC minus sine theta. Now BC is 3 and this is 0.6 minus 1. So just the negative of what we have got, the component of BC along AC. You know that component of a vector along another vector can be positive, can be negative, and can be zero. When first vector is making less than 90 degree with the second vector, the component of first vector along the second vector will be positive. When the first vector is making 90 degree with the second vector, in that condition the component of first vector along the second vector will be zero. And if the first vector is making more than 90 degree and less than 180 degree, in that condition the component of first vector along the second vector will be negative. So the component of a vector along another vector can be positive, can be negative, can be zero.